EPP, c'est un peu comme se rendre à une réunion de la de famille. Une famille réunie par des valeurs communes et un idéal partagé. Et cet idéal a un nom pour tout le monde, c'est l'Europe. Nous ne parlons pas ici d'une notion géographique, encore moins d'une machine bureaucratique. Nous parlons de l'Europe comme projet politique, comme idéal moral. L'Union européenne, sans aucun doute, la plus grande avancée du siècle, traverse aujourd'hui une crise majeure. Une crise qui dépasse la question cruciale de la dette et que l'on peut qualifier d'identitaire. Face au pessimisme ambiant, face à la montée du scepticisme, la famille PPE sera, j'en suis intimement convaincu, le moteur de la grande refondation européenne. Je suis venu ici avec un message simple, un message d'espoir. Non seulement le projet européen a un avenir, mais pour nous, voisins de l'Union, ce projet est l'avenir. Ladies and gentlemen, we heard the speech by our chairman, and we all know that the Russian Federation occupies militarily 20% of our territory in violation of ceasefire agreement and the international law. You are aware of the tragedy of 500,000 of my citizens, as we are a country of only 5 million people, who were expelled from their home because a former KGB officer in a faraway capital decided that their home was not their home anymore, but a playground for his neo-Soviet ambitions. You are aware that I want to express the gratitude of this very people of the Georgian nation that the European Parliament has just stuck to its highest moral principles and adopted a resolution on Georgia where European Parliament spoke of the occupation, illegal occupation of my territory, and for the first time since Balkan Wars has accused a military force of a major power in Europe of committing war crimes of ethnic cleansing. The latest proof is being the European Parliament, I think this is the latest proof of what this family means, because this was a resolution, of course, supported by absolute overwhelming majority of the European Parliament, but was originally advocated by the People's Party. So despite the occupation, the ethnic cleansing, the embargoes and the continuous threat, I came here to deliver a message of hope on behalf of my country as well. Look, Georgia that has been occupied, Georgia that has been proclaimed dead several years ago, right now is one of the best reform performers. We are the world's number one economic reformer according to the World Bank based on 5 years period. We are world's number one fighter of corruption according to the data of Transparency International based on five years period. We are the country that has second most efficient and transparent bureaucracy in the world according to Canadian Center of Law and Justice, Law and Democracy after New Zealand. And this is a country where these results have brought the results that, you know, poverty has decreased from 52% down to 17% and it's continuing to decrease. And the country that has tremendous social gains in terms of equality, in terms of advancing of social agenda, but at the same time, of course, of market economy and free liberal democracy and our own conservative values. And this and the country that, against all the odds, was also upgraded by Standard & Poor's just 2 weeks ago because of its economic and political performance. It's the Union, but that's exactly the thing that gains that we are bringing to the European Union. The Union is projecting stability and progress in its surroundings, and I think the European Union, against all the odds, is synonymous of peace, democracy, and prosperity. For the countries of Eastern Partnership, there is no alternative to Europe. Our paths might look different. Georgia might embrace quicker and more steadily the European political model than maybe some of the others, but at the end, there is no other solution than the European transformation of our societies, no other geopolitical choice than the European integration. What would be the alternative once again? What if Europe gets weaker? What if Europe disintegrates as some people fear, or maybe some people hope? What is the future then for our region? The Eurasian Union, as proposed by some nostalgic leaders in Moscow? The same project was imposed on Georgia and many other nations almost one century ago. It had another name, it was called the Soviet Union, and it had been tragedy for all of us. I spent my childhood or early youth in that country. I don't miss any bit of it at all. And I think lots of people, basically everybody around me, shares the same feeling. So if the European Union is the future, Eurasian Union is the past. If the European Union has the potential, and Europe has always found the way, that's what we learned from recent European history. Eurasian Union is still born, no matter what is the declaration right now. And this is very important to understand, because recent events in small occupied areas in Georgia called South Ossetia, where they've expelled 90% of the population, less than 10,000 people remain. Russian president went there for official visit. They staged elections, and they could not control even those staged elections. They campaigned for so-called presidential candidates in so-called elections, and it all degenerated into violence and ugly pictures. And I think this preempted what happened in the center of Moscow, and that have shown to us that the methods and the language of the past simply do not work anymore. I meet a lot with young people in my post-Soviet countries. I travel a lot to some of those countries. I can tell you, there is no way they will accept new Soviet Union in any form, under any name, under any pretext. And the present is sometimes chaotic, but the future belongs to democracies, open societies, free markets. In my region, this democratic future has one name only, and this is Europe. Europe, EPP is the natural home for these reformist forces that are building such a European future, and the EPP has to be the leading force in the neighborhood policy. Ladies and gentlemen, the principle of more for more adopted by the European Union is the right approach. The European Union proposed more cooperation and more integration to those who want it more act accordingly. Both in terms of economic and political transformation, we want to be a success case of neighborhood policy, a success story for the EU and for the EPP. Thank you.